गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन. टुडे वी हैव अ वीडियो डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन ऑन द ब्लड वेसल्स ऑफ हार्ट. तो नाउ द हार्ट इज इन द एनाटॉमिकल पोजिशन सच दैट दिस स्ट्रक्चर इज कॉल्ड एज राइट एट्रियम एंड दिस स्ट्रक्चर इज राइट वेंट्रिकल. एडजॉइनिंग दिस स्ट्रक्चर दिस थिकेस्ट चैम्बर इज द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल वेयर एज the chamber which is lying posteriorly, this is the left atrium. Is it clear? Now, keeping the heart in the anatomical position, we can see the vessels emerging out of the heart as well as some vessels which are entering inside the heart. Now, the vessels emerging out of the heart, great vessels are, number one, this is called as pulmonary trunk. As you all can see, the pulmonary trunk is emerging out from the right ventricle. This structure is the pulmonary trunk. And the structure behind this, this is called as aorta. This is called as aorta, which is emerging from the left ventricle. This structure is called as aorta. This part is ascending aorta. This is arch of aorta. Then it will continue further as descending aorta. We all know that arch of aorta has three branches. You can see from the right side, this is my right side. From the right to left, we have brachiocephalic trunk. Then we have left common carotid. And then we have left subclavian artery. These are the three branches from the arch of aorta. This vessel will carry the oxygenated blood to whole of the body from the left ventricle. This will carry the oxygenated blood and this artery is rich in elastic fibers. Now the second is the pulmonary trunk which emerges out of the right ventricle. This will carry the deoxygenated blood towards the lungs for further oxygenation and exchange of gases. Now what will happen? Right ventricle will contract. This will pass the blood to the pulmonary trunk. It will divide into two parts, the right and left. The right and the left, which will go to the respective lungs and will cause the oxygenation. Now the blood has been oxygenated by the right and left lung. Now it will come back to the heart. Heart, kahan pe aayega heart mein? It will enter the left atrium via these four structures are called as pulmonary veins. These four structures are called as pulmonary veins. Remember, yahan pe ulta hai, the pulmonary artery carries the deoxygenated blood, whereas the pulmonary veins, they are carrying the oxygenated blood from the lungs towards the heart. So these are four in number, opening into the left atrium of the heart. This is left atrium and these are four pulmonary veins. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are entering the left chamber of the heart, the left atrium of the heart. Is it clear? Now the blood, oxygenated blood from the left atrium will go into the left ventricle and from the left ventricle it will pump to the whole of the body via the aorta, which is divided into ascending arch of aorta as well as descending aorta. Now we will discuss the coronary circulation. Coronary circulation supply the heart itself, the walls of the heart itself. As we all know that heart is continuously pumping and its muscles also need oxygen. For this oxygen, the muscles need oxygenated blood to pump. Now they require the oxygenated blood. Now from where the oxygenated blood will come to the walls of the heart? From this vessel. This is the aorta. Aorta ka jo ascending part hai, starting mein, as soon as it emerges out of the heart, it gives out coronary vessels. One is the right coronary vessel and another is the left coronary vessels. I'll show you in different heart. Now this is another heart. The circulation, the vessels are very clean here. We have cleaned up the coronary vessels and traced the course of the coronary vessels. Now this structure was pulmonary trunk. This was right ventricle. As you all know, this is the front surface, sternocostal surface. And my hand is the diaphragm, diaphragmatic surface. This will be the diaphragmatic surface, and posteriorly we will have the left atrium. You can see this is right atrium and this is right ventricle. Jab right ventricle ko open kiya, we can see the various structure, and this structure is the pulmonary trunk. Behind the pulmonary trunk, I have removed this structure. This is the aorta, and I have cut the aorta to show you the aortic sinuses. Now you can see there are three aortic sinuses. One is anteriorly, while keeping the heart in the anatomical position, this is the anterior aortic sinus, which will give origin to the right coronary artery, whereas we have two posterior aortic sinuses. These flaps, these are aortic sinuses. One is anterior and two are posterior. The anterior one gives origin to the right coronary artery, whereas the left posterior one, it gives origin to the left coronary artery, and the right posterior, it remains non-coronary. It does not give out any coronary arteries. Is it clear? Aorta जहाँ से originate करता है वहाँ पर three aortic sinuses होते हैं, एक anterior होता है, दो posterior होते हैं. Anterior वाला gives origin to the right coronary artery, left posterior वाला it gives origin to the left coronary artery, right posterior वाला खाली रहता है. Are you able to see this hole? Actually this is the origin of the coronary artery. Is it clear? Now we will discuss the course of the right as well as the left coronary artery. First of all, the right coronary artery. It is smaller as compared to the left coronary artery. We will discuss it now. Now, this right coronary artery, first it runs in which groove? The groove between the atrium and ventricle is called as coronary sulcus or the atrioventricular sulcus. This depression is called as atrioventricular sulcus, where the coronary artery runs, the right as well as the left side. Isn't it? Now the first, it passes between the, this is called auricle and the pulmonary trunk. जब हम right coronary artery की बात करते हैं तो जैसे ही वो निकलती है, emerge out होती है, it runs between the right auricle as well as the pulmonary trunk. ठीक है, then it passes downwards and to the right. अब ये right side पे आ गई है, ठीक है, इसलिए इसको right coronary artery बोलते हैं. That is why this is called as right coronary artery. Now at the junction of right border and the inferior border, this is inferior border and this is right border, इसके junction पे this artery moves backwards. First this artery runs in anterior aspect, then it runs in posterior aspect. This is anterior atrioventricular sulcus and this is posterior atrioventricular sulcus. Coronary artery right wali jaise nikalti hai wo right or inferior border pe, it turns itself posteriorly. Now you can see this is the right coronary artery. Now it is running between the right atrium and right ventricle at the diaphragmatic surface. Now at the junction of coronary sulcus and interventricular, this is posterior, do ventricles ke beech mein, this is posterior interventricular sulcus. At the junction of the posterior interventricular sulcus and coronary sulcus, this artery moves downwards. You can see this artery is going downwards. Now this artery is named as posterior interventricular artery. ये diaphragmatic surface है, नीचे वाली surface जो diaphragm के contact में है. This artery is called as posterior interventricular artery and it also gives some branches which anastomose with the left coronary artery. At the diaphragmatic surface, the right coronary and the left coronary artery, they anastomose with each other. This artery is called as posterior interventricular artery. Now during its course we can see this branch. Are you able to see this branch? This is called as marginal artery. Ye marginal artery jati hai aur apex tak jati hai. This artery is called as marginal artery. Now we will see the branches of the right coronary artery. As it is passing on the right side between the atrium and ventricle, It will give branches to the right atrium as well as to the right ventricle. Is it clear? हमने अभी देखा इट इज़ गोइंग पोस्टीरियरली, इट इज़ गिविंग पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर ब्रांच. नेचुरल सी बात है, इट विल ऑल्सो सप्लाई दिस एरिया. दिस स्ट्रक्चर इज कॉल्ड एज राइट वेंट्रिकल. इट विल सप्लाई द राइट वेंट्रिकल एंड ऑल्सो अ पार्ट ऑफ द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल एडजॉइनिंग टू द पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर ग्रुप. इट विल ऑल्सो गिव मार्जिनल ब्रांच, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. इट विल गिव टर्मिनल ब्रांचेज. इट विल ऑल्सो गिव नोडल ब्रांचेज इन 60% केसेस. नोडल का मतलब वो ऐसे नोड को भी ब्रांचेज देती है, ए वी नोड को भी ब्रांचेज देती है, ए वी बंडल को भी ब्रांच देती है, बट ऑन द राइट राइट ब्रांच ऑफ ए वी बंडल इज सप्लाइड बाई द राइट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी, वेयर एज द लेफ्ट ब्रांच ऑफ ए वी बंडल इज बींग सप्लाइड बाई द लेफ्ट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द एरियाज ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द राइट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी. It will supply the right atrium as it is on right side. It will supply the right atrium. It will supply the ventricles. The greater part of the right ventricle is being supplied by the right coronary artery. Up posteriorly, it will also supply the right ventricle posteriorly as this is the posterior interventricular branch. Posterior interventricular क्या करती है, थोड़ा थोड़ा left ventricle को भी branches देती है. तो इट विल सप्लाई द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल ऑल्सो बट नॉट कम्प्लीटली, अ बिट एडजॉइनिंग द पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर ग्रूव. इज इट क्लियर? इट विल सप्लाई द पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर सेप्टम ऑल्सो, प्लस इट विल गिव द नोडल ब्रांचेस टू सप्लाई द कंडक्टिंग सिस्टम ऑफ द हार्ट एक्सेप्ट द लेफ्ट ब्रांच ऑफ ए वी बंडल. इज इट क्लियर? नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द लेफ्ट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी. Left coronary artery is larger than the right because it has a larger course comparatively to the right coronary artery. Right coronary artery arises from the aortic sinus. अभी बताया था, it arises from the left posterior aortic sinus. अब it is on left side, तो it lies between these two structures. Can you see this structure and this? This was called as pulmonary trunk and this is called as auricle of left side. तो इट लाइज बिटवीन द लेफ्ट ऑरिकल एंड द पल्मोनरी ट्रंक. सबसे फर्स्ट पॉइंट. नाउ हेयर इट गिव्स अ ब्रांच दैट इज कॉल्ड एज लेफ्ट एंटीरियर डिसेंडिंग. ये वाली, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज लेफ्ट एंटीरियर डिसेंडिंग, या फिर इसको नाम देते हैं एंटीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरी. आई विल शो दिस आर्टरी इन दिस हार्ट. इट इज़ वेरी क्लियर हेयर. नाउ यू कैन सी दिस इज एओर्टा, ठीक है, एंड दिस इज लेफ्ट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी. लेफ्ट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी जैसे ही निकलती है, इट गिव्स अ ब्रांच विच रन्स ऑन द एंटीरियर सरफेस बिटवीन द राइट वेंट्रिकल एंड द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल इन द इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर ग्रूव. इसलिए इसको नाम दे दिया एंटीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरी. दिस आर्टरी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज लेफ्ट एंटीरियर डिसेंडिंग. ना होता क्या है, दिस लेफ्ट एंटीरियर डिसेंडिंग और एंटीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरी फर्स्ट रन्स ऑन द वेंट्रल सरफेस. दिस सरफेस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज स्टर्नोकॉस्टल सरफेस. फर्स्ट इट रन्स ऑन द स्टर्नोकॉस्टल सरफेस, देन इट टर्न्स पोस्टीरियरली ऑन द डायफ्रामेटिक सरफेस. देन इट टर्न्स पोस्टीरियरली ऑन द डायफ्रामेटिक सरफेस टू एनेस्टमोज विद अनदर आर्टरी दैट इज कॉल्ड एज पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरी. इज इट क्लियर? तो एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरीज दे एनेस्टमोज विद ईच अदर. नाउ फर्दर, आफ्टर इट गिव्स द एंटीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर ब्रांच, इट कंटिन्यूज एज सर्कुम्फ्लेक्स आर्टरी. नाउ यू कैन सी दिस आर्टरी इज सर्कुम्फ्लेक्स आर्टरी. ये पूरी आर्टरी है सर्कुम्फ्लेक्स आर्टरी. Is it clear? It runs as the circumflex artery between the left atrium and the left ventricle in the left coronary sulcus. First it moves anteriorly, then it moves on the posterior atrioventricular sulcus or the coronary sulcus. As soon as it turns the posterior atrioventricular sulcus, it gives a branch, this branch, this is called as a diagonal artery. This artery is called as diagonal artery which goes to the apex of the heart. ये apex of heart तक जाती है. It is a branch from the left coronary artery. You can see it is giving this branch. This is called as diagonal branch.
then it continues on the posterior atrioventricular sulcus and anastomose with the right coronary artery at the crux of heart. Is it clear? So this is the course of the left coronary artery. Now the branches, first branch, it gives the anterior interventricular branch, second it gives the diagonal branch, then it will supply the left atrium. As it is on left side, it will give the left atrial branches, the left ventricular branches, then terminal and pulmonary branches. Now the areas of distribution, मैंने बता दिया कि वो लेफ्ट एट्रियम को सप्लाई करेगी, लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल को सप्लाई करेगी. इट विल सप्लाई द ग्रेटर पार्ट ऑफ द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल एक्सेप्ट द एरिया एडजॉइनिंग द पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर ग्रूव विच इज बीइंग सप्लाइड बाय द राइट कोरोनरी आर्टरी. इट विल ऑल्सो सप्लाई द ब्रांच, लेफ्ट ब्रांच ऑफ द एवी बंडल. इट विल ऑल्सो गिव अ ब्रांच टू द लेफ्ट पार्ट ऑफ एट्रियोवेंट्रिकुलर बंडल. नाउ एक टर्म है कार्डियक डोमिनेंस. कार्डियक डोमिनेंस क्या होता है? कार्डियक डोमिनेंस इज डिटरमाइंड बाई द पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरी. ज़्यादातर केसेस में जो पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरी है, ये ब्रांच होती है राइट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी की. इन अप्रोक्सीमेटली 90% केसेस, द पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरी इज अ ब्रांच फ्रॉम द राइट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी, दैट इज कॉल्ड राइट कार्डियक डोमिनेंस. But in some cases, it may be a branch. In around 10% cases, it is a branch from the left coronary artery. उस केस में हम कहते हैं the it is left cardiac dominance. ज़्यादातर right की ही branch होती है, कभी कभी left की भी branch हो जाती है. Now we will discuss the venous drainage of heart. Venous drainage of heart में the first structure is the coronary sinus. The first structure is the coronary sinus. This is the front surface, sternocostal surface, and this is the diaphragmatic surface. ये structure जो open करी हुई है, this structure is right atrium. As you all know that this structure is right atrium. On the posterior wall of right atrium, we receive a vessel. This vessel is called as the coronary sinus. It is the largest vein of the heart. ये वाली, ये. This is the largest vein of the heart. It is situated in the left posterior coronary sulcus. It ends in the right atrium of the heart. अब जितनी भी venous drainage है, जितनी भी छोटी छोटी veins हैं, सारी की सारी जाएंगी coronary sinus में. Coronary sinus itself drains into the right atrium. As you people all know that right atrium receives the deoxygenated blood via the superior and the inferior vena cava, plus it also receives the deoxygenated blood via the coronary sinus also. Coronary sinus itself carries the deoxygenated blood from the walls of the heart via some small veins. Now the first vein is the great cardiac vein. You people know that this is the anterior interventricular sulcus. Just close to this bluish structure, we can see this is the great cardiac vein. This is the great cardiac vein. Where it lies, it is present, the great cardiac vein is present in the atrioventricular sulcus. It joins the coronary sinus on the left aspect. Is it clear? We can see that this is the coronary sinus, and on the left end of the coronary sinus joins the great cardiac vein. Now can you see this structure? This structure, ye to thi posterior interventricular artery, and this structure is the middle cardiac vein. मिडल कार्डियक वेन किसको एकम्पनी करती है? पोस्टीरियर इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर आर्टरी को एकम्पनी करती है और जाके ओपन करती है कॉर्नरी साइनस में. यू कैन सी इट जॉइंट्स द कॉर्नरी साइनस. द स्मॉल कार्डियक वेन, इट एकम्पनीज द राइट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी इन द कॉर्नरी सल्कस एंड जॉइंट्स द कॉर्नरी साइनस ऑन द राइट आस्पेक्ट. इट फॉलोज द राइट कॉर्नरी आर्टरी. देन वी हैव अनदर स्मॉल वेन्स like oblique vein of left atrium, we have the right marginal vein and the posterior vein of left ventricle. All the veins, they drain into the coronary sinus, and coronary sinus itself drains into the right atrium of heart. Thank you, students.